रिटेल मैनेजमेंट मास्टर्स ऑफ कॉमर्स फोर्थ सेमेस्टर मैंगलोर यूनिवर्सिटी सेशन 25। रिटेल मार्केटिंग रिटेल प्रमोशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन मिक्स। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द रिटेल प्रमोशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन मिक्स। सेशन आउटकम द स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द इनसाइट्स ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड मार्केटिंग कम्युनिकेशन। From times unknown, retailers have tried to attract the customers towards their products and services, and more importantly, their store through the novel methods. At one point of time, few decades back, the retailer seems to know the names of the customers as well as their nature of purchase. On the other hand, customers used to associate themselves with a specific store based on the relationship they had with the retailer. That was an era which was marked by lesser number of stores as well as equally lesser number of customers. Over a period of time, things have changed drastically to make the customers more demanding. To make things grimmer, there has been a quantum jump in the number of stores as well as individual sizes of major stores. All these stores have led to a situation whereby the customers are on the lookout for the best bargain. The purchase decision is just not based on relationship but on hardcore monetary gain and the experience quotient derived out of the shopping transaction. All this has made marketing communication a significantly critical area from the source point of view. This is because customer visits are perception based in the first instance, and there onwards it is based on their own experience. Whether it is a matter of perception for a first time visit or a satisfying experience with the store and a sense of happiness for transacting with the store, all depends upon the marketing communication strategy of the store. The reasons governing the changed customer attitude. Scarcity of time. Majority of the families are dual earning and have various commitments to attend. Thus, they face a paucity of time to invest in purchase transaction. With increasing distances, a major part of the consumer time is consumed in commuting. This leads to an increase in time cost for the customer. Thus, they have become very conscious about the time factor. Second is a lifestyle and status. Customers in general have developed a great sense of individualism. People follow distinct lifestyles and would not like to compromise there. This leads to an intensive search by the customer for specific product types and styles. Thus, the customers would like to confirm whether the retail outlet has a perception amongst the customers which matches their preference. The retailer should take this scenario in his stead and sincerely work to establish a positive image. At the same time, it should be his endeavor to communicate to the customer about the range of products and services which can satisfy the customers at the prices which suit the customers. Next is retail marketing communication. All means adopted by a retail store to communicate a store-specific message to the customers constitute the retail marketing communication. Therefore, we can say whatever a store does to communicate to the target audience regarding the visit worthiness of the store can come under the broad heading of retail marketing communication. The basic tasks of communication. First, intimate the customers about the presence of a store or outlet. Second, invite them to visit the store and make it really an attractive proposition to do so. Third, amidst all the media clutter, making a consistent effort to remind them to do so. It has often been experienced that some promotional schemes have been introduced in the market by manufacturer's brand. This is backed by heavy advertising and publicity. However, when the customer goes to purchase the same brand, he either does not find it available or, more surprisingly, the store is not aware of the scheme being offered. This anomaly or inconsistency can be minimized by the integration of the communication strategy. The primary function of any marketing communication strategy is to increase the footfalls in the store. This footfall can be increased by informing the customer about the store and motivating him to do so. Differentiation from competitors is also a major function of marketing communication. Here, it is worth mentioning that marketing communication strategy will be very different for large retail chains vis-a-vis single unit retail stores. A large retail chain based on multiple geographical location has diverse audiences to address to. Thus, the communication strategy can be fine-tuned as per need of the store. However, it is very important to remember that even in case of the fine-tuning of communication strategy, the identity of the store remains the same. Strategy has to be such that the image and the identity of the chain remains the same. Next is integrated marketing communication. Integrated marketing communication consists of pure of communication tools. It includes the first is the advertising. It would include all the paid forms of non-personal presentation of ideas to promote the store. Advertising gives a reason to buy from the specific store to the customers. Here we can conclude all the advertisements in the press, television and all other forms of media. The latest type of advertisement in the press is known as advertorial. In this case, a detailed report is prepared and presented in the form of a press report in the newspaper, which is actually not so. These reports or other promotional materials are presented in an innovative manner so that the customer or the reader takes it as a genuinely covered press report. The second is the sales promotion. It includes off-season discounts, off-season sales, free gifts, most valued customer schemes, etc. Sales promotion gives an incentive to buy from that store as against the mission of advertising to give a reason to buy. It has been seen over the years that sales promotion have been successful in boosting sales even if for the promotion period only. The retailers must be cautious while introducing such schemes as it leads to counter schemes by competitors towards as well as a sharp dip in sales after the promotion is over. The third is publicity. All activities which give some sort of positive or negative image of the basis on the basis of activities done by the store come under the broad heading of publicity. For instance, if a big retail store for some charitable activity to help some underprivileged cross-section of society and it generates media interest which leads to media coverage, then we can term it as publicity. It has been experienced that publicity is more effective in tone for promotion other than advertising. However, stores should refrain from getting into controversial areas to avoid any negative publicity which may adversely affect its image amongst the target audience. Next is direct marketing. All forms of store promotion through brochures, catalogs, and internet can be categorized under the broad heading of direct marketing. Direct marketing has been very popular in Western countries but not so much in India. It has been seen that transactions through the net have not been that popular in India. Reasons can be attributed to problems related to the product delivery and payment while transacting through net. However, we must bear this in mind that in comparison to advertising, direct marketing proves to be a cheaper and effective medium for store promotion. The greatest advantage of direct marketing is that it not only draws attention of the customers for visiting the store but also presents an opportunity to buy products over the phone or through the internet. Next is personal selling. Personal selling is an integral part of integrated marketing communication. When a store uses its sales force to give personal attention to the customer and follow up in a personalized manner, it becomes an effective tool for sales store promotion. At times, store personnel do visit the customers at their residence to develop an intimacy and obviously promote the store. Next is public relations. The image a store develops through its public dealings like interaction with the customers, enthusiasm amongst the store employees and customers' grievance handling mechanism constitutes public relationships or PR. The concept of integrated marketing communication as it is popularly known simply states that all the tools of marketing communication mentioned above should be used in tandem to achieve the organizational goals. Further, you should appreciate that all these tools have their own unique characteristics to communicate the specific message in a distinct manner. You should understand that all these tools, when applied together or in short intervals, should never deliver a different message or image of the store. For example, if a particular retail store hires top-notch models to inaugurate the store backed up with zazzy advertising campaign, it definitely carves out an image in the minds of the customer. However, if the customers perceive through word of mouth communication that the store does not offer such premium products as was expected in line with the image formed, it may result in a sharp decline in footfalls in the store. Similarly, after such an advertising campaign, if the publicity generated by the activities of the store is unable to match the image, even then it will lead to fiasco for the store. The bottom line there is all the tools of marketing communication have to perform in a coordinated manner as instruments in an orchestra. We can put the retail store at the core of this mix at the time of need, arousal. The customer has several questions. These questions can be: which product to buy that satisfies the present need? Which brand of the product to buy? Next, which store to purchase from? And last is whether to purchase from a single store or compare the offerings at various stores. So many communication variables influence the decision to do shopping at a particular retail outlet. Given the fact that there are multiple retailers and multiple products trying to convince the customers with the messages, the role of marketing communication becomes very critical.